So how to change or service your CV joints on your sand car. This has the 930 CVs. It's a 2D transmission, mid-engine, so it's pretty easy to get to. First you'll need to take off your clamp. Mine had little band clamps, so it made it pretty easier. Once you pull your boot off or back, you should see something like this. What you'll need, a Dremel, a lot of gloves, Dykes if you have zip ties, small screwdriver or scribe. I'm using a ratchet with a number 8 Allen and a larger screwdriver for the band clamp. I'm using Redden Tacky Lucas grease, and you'll need a jack, a drain or wash pan, and I'm using gas to clean the parts. Once you jack up the car, take your rag, clean out as much of the grease as you can get. Here's to start with. Start pulling your bolts. Once you get your bolts out, it should come off pretty easy. There is a small clamp or E-ring right here. You'll need to take that off, then your whole CV will slide off the end, and then you start washing it. Once you have all your parts washed off, you'll want to inspect them. You start with the star or whatever, and look, fill in the grooves and look at them. If there's any burrs, or this one has a little light pitting, I'm going to clean up with the Dremel. Go ahead and do that. Same for the outer ring. Fill in each of the grooves. Make sure you don't have any spurs or anything for the balls to get caught on. So once you have that back to however you want, nice and smooth, you don't want to put it back together. Mine has this little ring here which goes towards the transmission, so I'm going to put that down. On your cage, one side is bigger than the other, so take your little tape measure, measure it out. Once you figure out what side is bigger, you'll put that side out. On your spur, but if you notice, there's a small, big, small, big, small, big. And also, on your outer ring, there's a big, small, big, small. Now you put them opposite. So once you get it in your cage, you're going to have small, big, big, small. Small, big, big, small. Either way. Opposite. You put that in there and have them opposite. Then you'll want to put in your balls one at a time. It's just going to be a little easier with two hands, so I'm going to go ahead and do that. So So I went ahead and Dremeled out all of the crevices to get them all nice and smooth. Put the bearings in. Put the little cover on the outside just to hold it in there good. Once you have it all back together how you want it, go ahead and inspect your drive line. Make sure you don't have any broken teeth or anything. Eventually I'm going to pack the cup full of grease. Pack this side full of grease. Slide it on there. Put the E-clip back. And bolt it back up on here. Holding it while you're getting your clip back on. The inside, so I'm going to use blue. Pretty well use about half a tube or so on each side. So since there was no tubs of grease available at the parts store when I went up there, I'm using a tube. And to get it out, take the top off your grease gun. Go ahead and stick the tube in there like you would normally do. Release your lock. And it may shoot back up like mine did, or maybe not. But either way, you just push it down slowly until you start getting the amount of grease you want out, and repeat until you're done. Once you get everything greased up, go through and snug up your bolts. Getting adding a little bit more torque until you have it where you want them. I have a calibrated elbow, so it makes it a little bit easier. I don't have to break out the torque wrench. Snugged up how you want it. Go ahead and slide your boot back on. Put your clamp on. I have a zip tie on the bottom. Put the zip tie on. And take her out for a test drive. Take it slow for the first couple miles. Let the grease get all through the CV joint before you really get on it. Alright. Have fun.